Yorkers shocked to see what appeared on site of World Trade Center overnight HRS after attack. New Yorkers nearly broke down into tears as they stood strong after what happened on Halloween of 2017. Halloween was supposed to be marred by liberals tormenting souls who dare dress as controversially and liberally destroyed costumes such as the White Power Princess Elsa or culturally appropriated Mona. But those liberal dreams of destroying children's dreams across America came to a screeching halt, and someone else pressed on the gas pedal on a rented Home Depot truck. One of those Allahu Akbar shouting Muslim terrorists drove full steam ahead in the bike lane, mowing down pedestrians in NYC. 8 dead. 12 injured. Tears and blood pooling into the streets like a small river forming in the concrete. Allahu Akbar, the man said as a hero cop blasted him with a service weapon and put a stop to the mayhem just after the terrorist crashed into a school bus and ran out of his rented work truck with fake guns. Thankfully, the school bus was there to start the end of the chaos, and the cop finished it off by chasing him and putting a shot into him, just enough to get him arrested and detained. Cleanup began and people resiliently picked their friends and family up off the ground in NYC. The news covered the event, President Trump crushed Chuck Schumer, and the left and right spun their own version of the radical Islamic terrorist story. Everything happened that usually happens after one of these attacks. Then people looked up at the site of the World Trade Center overnight and noticed something that made them lift their down soul, pick their head up high, and remember that we are Americans strong and nothing breaks us. Their eyes peered up the side of the meticulous building, and that's when they noticed the spire of the tower was illuminated in the proud colors of red, white, and blue for American pride and strength. The spire of One World Trade Center was lit up red, white, and blue in honor of freedom and democracy on the orders of New York Governor Andrew Cuomo. New York City is on high alert after 8 people were run down and killed by a man driving a rental truck down a riverfront bike path on the Lower West Side of Manhattan. The Twin Towers site was just a few blocks from the scene of the carnage, which was caused when the suspect swerved the pickup onto a path filled with pedestrians and bicyclists on a sunny, crisp autumn afternoon. Ordering a red, white, and blue lights be turned on at the top of One World Trade Center, Governor Cuomo said, "I am deeply saddened by the attack on New York, and I join all New Yorkers in mourning the innocent lives we lost today." Cuomo listed this as the international symbol of democracy and freedom, although he has been criticized by numerous people because he labeled the attack as a lone wolf incident. How can he be sure so soon after the attack? It's only been hours since the authorities had their hands on the attacker, so there probably hasn't been sufficient time for questioning and investigations. Investigators have to dig into the attacker's history, personal life, and whom he's connected to. There is likely some sort of information the investigation will unravel and reveal to the world, but it might be kept confidential in respect to national security. Investigators would be smart to keep their details under wraps so they don't give away too much information that could potentially ruin any chances they have of thwarting an attack by an associate or uncovering a deep connection to ISIS or any other similar types of useful information. This attack has been noted as the deadliest terrorist attack in that area since the hijackers crashed airplanes into the World Trade Center, killing thousands of people. The truck attack is very small in comparison, but still not something that should ever happen. There's simply no point nor accomplishment acquired by terrorists when they commit these horrendous attacks. The terrorist always ends up killed or in jail, so what's the point of doing something that ends their life? The terrorists aren't remembered or considered important, they're basically human sacrifices, and they don't even get their 72 virgins in the sky when they're perishing. Terrorist acts are pointless. And there's much better ways to get a point across, if there ever is a point to be made. While far-left liberals are parading themselves like the best thing on earth, prancing about their ideals with cultural appropriation and being victims of politically incorrect humor or chanting about Islamophobia, there's real-life things going on where people are getting killed. At what point do people stop saying Islamophobia and start recognizing the true existence of terror? Thank you to Cuomo for lighting up the spire, but I'm sure people can't wait to get him out of office.